How's it going, my fuzzy family? My name is Panda Hub, and that was Mrs. Panda.
Oh, fuck.
And welcome to the long-awaited 300-sub special. So we've got a large variety of different things that are going to be happening into this video so far. But first off, I want to say thank you, everyone, so much. Thank you so much. I mean, the channel is now at, hold on, let me check. 336 by the time that I'm recording this, which is 9:13 p.m. See, look. 336 subscribers. About almost 2.5 weeks ago, we ended up hitting 300 subscribers. At the end of March, we ended up hitting 300 subs. That is 3 consecutive months where we've gained 100 subscribers per month on the channel. And I'm just completely baffled on how fast the channel is growing. I mean, we're already at 2.5 weeks. We're almost at 350 subscribers. That's fucking amazing. So thank you all so much for such an amazing and exciting journey. Now, going on to the next part, which I'll be adding in the snippets for them here in just a moment, but I asked you on Twitter to post questions for my 300 sub special, and I would go ahead and answer them. Now I'm gonna go in order for when, you know, each post came in, so then that way it kind of keeps it in a retrospective pattern. It makes it a little bit easier to follow along and a little bit more exciting. Say hi to Mrs. Panda again. But so the first question that I remember getting was actually from a good friend of mine, which you guys have seen in some of my, well, heard at least in some of my channels, and some of the episodes that I've done on the channel, is Unicycle Gaming. He is actually dated April the 5th. I'm not going to be doing the timestamp, but that's where we're starting from. And the first question that I got, which was from him, was, when is your wife going to do your makeup? Now, I remember back in one of my videos, I stated that I was going to be doing a special for you guys where my wife was going to be doing my makeup and playing games after she did the makeup or during when she did the makeup. I haven't decided just yet, but she's going to be doing the makeup during this video, which I'm kind of nervous about, not for the fact of her doing my makeup, but for the fact of how horrifying I will look.
What are you trying to say? I'm bad at makeup?
No, I'm trying to say that I'm terrified on how I will look because I don't want to scare the children.
I'll make you pretty.
Make me fabulous, just like my hair?
Yes. Fabulous.
But, you know, Uni, just to let you know, she is going to be doing the makeup in this video, because along with this, you know, reading the questions as you guys provided me, I'm also going to be doing the makeup and playing a game. So it's going to be a very long special, but I wanted to say thank you and also do the questions and then try to do the makeup and then the video game. I haven't decided which game that I'm going to be playing just yet. It's probably going to be a game that I either received from Keymailer or a game that I already have. But we'll definitely go ahead and wait and see. Funny enough, I may just end up doing my second episode of Sticks while wearing makeup, but I don't know 100%. But then again, that is considered to be terrifying. I mean, the game is already, you know, mouth movements aren't exactly the prettiest. But anyways, going on to the next question, which comes from Bloodshot Gamer 1. Really good really good friend of Unicycle and mine. He asks, what made you start trying to do YouTube? Which I've noticed that there are a lot of other questions that are repeated. You know, it's very similar in some of the questions, but I'll make sure to go ahead and answer each one. What made me decide to start doing YouTube was the fact that, I don't know, what was it? A couple years ago, I decided I was just talking about it. I was saying how it'd be a really cool idea to actually start doing YouTube.
Watched a lot of people do it.
Yeah, I watched like some of the other YouTubers. Like, I started watching Mark when he wasn't very big. You know, this was a couple of years ago. And I just remember watching how, you know, his reactions were and how the gameplay was. And I thought it was just, I thought it was fantastic. I thought it was awesome. And just being the, having the capability of sharing the gameplay, oh my god, my hair looks fucking awesome. Anyways, enough conceitedness for me. But, you know, and then after watching Babyface Mark go to who he is now, you know, I was just like, you know what? I have to get into doing YouTube. I have to be able to start doing Let's Plays, not for the fact of trying to make money, because that's the least of my worries. You know, I can work a day job, that's just fine. I have no problem working a day job. But the reason why I wanted to start doing YouTube, or what made me start trying to do YouTube, was, I was greatly interested in doing YouTube from watching Markiplier, LordMinion777, Moiskerm, as well as Jacksepticeye. There was also Game Grumps.
Yeah.
I mean, Cinnamon Toast Ken. I mean, there's a lot of different YouTubers that are commonly known and widely known. You know, Razbowski is another one. You know, Sim Supply is another one. You know, James. I mean, there's a lot of different YouTubers that I ended up started watching because I was so heavily into gaming, but I didn't have the money to start doing my own gaming channel in the beginning, and I didn't have a computer. Oh my god. Yeah, that's going to be an edit. But you know, basically, I started recording when I got a really good computer from my cousin. And
shout out to Nick.
Yeah, shout out to my cousin Nicholas. Great guy. He goes by Odeon. He's right now a PR lead for Rocket League. I know that he hosts a lot of games and stuff through Rocket League. So if you guys end up coming across like his stream channel or something, I believe it's going to be on Twitch, and it should be under Odeon, Odiahn, if I remember correctly. But anyways, you know, it's just something that really kind of captivated me. It was something that, you know, made me extremely intrigued on trying to do a Let's Play. You know, and if I had the capability of doing a Let's Play, to find out if I was able to run it properly, or be able to, if I was even good enough. You know, I was so concerned on what so many people thought of so many other people, like so many other Let's Players. And I was so concerned and wrapped up on, for the longest time, fear stopped me. Like, you know, you can even ask my wife, you know, honey, how often did fear actually stop me from recording? Like,
a lot.
I was terrified of trying to do a Let's Play, right? You know? And, you know, I didn't think that I was going to be good enough. I didn't think people were actually going to take the time to watch my content. Because, you know, here I am, another guy who's trying to do Let's Plays, trying to do, you know, all I'm trying to do is share my experiences with the games that I play. So, you know, there's so many different aspects as to why I originally wanted to try and start doing Let's Plays or doing YouTube in general. And mainly it was just wanting to share my experiences with the games that I played. And, you know, maybe with the fact of, I don't know. There's just different aspects of as to why I wanted to play, but mainly it's I wanted to share the gameplays that I do. I mean, I have no real reason as to why I wanted to start doing YouTube. I don't want to. I mean, I can't say that it wouldn't be cool to meet, you know, any other large end YouTuber or to make YouTube friends or anything like that. I mean, I've already got a plethora of them. You know, like Bloodshot, Uni, Shannon, Tazhole, you know, Elvish Gaming. I mean, there's just a lot of different ones that I continuously speak with from time to time. And, you know, I actually play with them, and me and Mrs. Panda play together with them. And, oh my god, so many fucking edits. You know, and I'm just going to leave them in. I don't care at this point. You guys can experience how much effort and work I put into this by yawning. Yeah, okay. Anyways, going on to the next question, from Thomas Fishing Thingy, he actually has two questions. First question is, what is my favorite food? Oh, gosh. Well, that's a favorite type of food. I mean, that's well, like...
Not a type of food, they're a food.
A type
of food would be like Mexican food.
They are a type of food. I'm considering them a type of
They're
food.
They're a whole food group?
Yes. Pizza rolls, a whole food group.
Ranch is your favorite food.
Yeah, yeah, ranch, completely. No, but my favorite type of food, I'd have to say, is, and there's no ironically or stereotypical just because of my channel name. The reason why I like this food group is because, or this type of food, is because of the different flavors and genres and the different styles of cooking that you can get done out of it. And I personally love Chinese food. And that, again, isn't based off of my channel name, or nor do I have some large affinity with Panda Express. I just really like Chinese food. My favorite type of food is either lo mein or chow mein. Mixed in with some vegetables, or I can have steamed rice or fuck, I'm just making myself
fried
hungry.
Rice.
Fried rice.
Just making yourself hungry.
Yeah. And usually it's like orange or sesame chicken. That's just, you know, which is funny because I normally cannot eat regular chicken.
You love orange chicken so much I've had to make it from scratch.
Yeah. Like, I've asked my wife to make orange chicken from scratch. Like, full-on orange peel and everything else.
Yeah, like,
and
make the sauce from scratch.
Yeah, and it's funny, you know, as I was just telling my wife, is I cannot eat normal chicken.
You can, it's just not your favorite.
I hate eating normal. I have to have chicken with ranch in order for me to eat it. I cannot eat normal chicken.
Just by itself.
Yeah, by itself. Like, if I have it mixed in with something, or if I have another wholesome food group, then sure, I can eat it, but, you know, and, but anyways, you know, like I was saying, my favorite food is Chinese food, and I gave an explanation as to which type of Chinese food I liked. There's no specification. If it's Chinese food, I'll eat it. I do have a score ranking as to how specific Chinese food restaurants are. Because there has to be a certain way with the orange chicken. And I'm not talking about Panda Express. I'm talking about it has to taste like you're biting into an orange that has a little bit of a kick. Fucking edits.
It's gonna be so much fun. Is that the new word for yawn? It's not a yawn, it's an edit.
Yeah.
I feel like I'm gonna edit.
Yeah, I feel like I'm gonna edit instead of yawn. But anyways, going on to the next question that Thomas asked was, do you know where Finland is? As far as I know, Finland is in the European country. No, it's going to be in the European country.
Continent.
Continent.
Europe is a continent.
I'm tired. Anyways, that's going to be an edit as well, so I'm going to just start this over. Do I know where Finland is the second question that Thomas asked me. It's going to be in the European continent. I don't know where specifically in the region, like, it's geographical, like, actual coordinates, but I know where it is. I've never been there, and
I've seen pictures. It looks very beautiful.
Yeah, it's very beautiful.
Based
on pictures that my wife and I have seen, but we don't have the funds to try and travel anywhere. It'd be kind of cool. Yeah, we have a one-year-old, so it's kind of hard for us to travel at the moment anyways. But if we ever end up going there, you know, it'd be kind of cool to get a tour from Thomas. Yeah, a tour.
Be our tour guide.
Yeah, be our tour guide, Thomas. You know, give us the ropes. But, you know, that's... I don't know specifically, unfortunately, and I wish that I could give you a straight answer. I mean, that's about as straight of an answer as you're going to get.
It doesn't require much of more than it's in Europe.
Yeah, it's in Europe. That's pretty much the best way that I can answer it. So the next question that I got is from MC Gaming. Great content, by the way, from Unicycle, Bloodshot, MC, DC Games. I mean, there's a lot of different gaming channel Let's Players that have, you know, followed me on Twitter and subscribed to my channel and actually follow consistently. So again, thank you guys so much for checking out this episode today. But going right along onto the next question from MC Gaming, they asked, what kind of panda are you? I'm the panda. I am the panda. I am labeling myself as the panda.
You're not a panda.
I am the panda. I am the very first panda.
You know what kind of panda you are? You're the kind that got that nickname from somebody.
Yes.
And that's it.
Yes. We will get back to that here in a little bit
there's a specific question
for that. But, Oh God. Fire. Anyways, I have to turn on the fan if I'm going to be vaping.
Okay.
Anyways, what kind of panda I am? I believe the type of panda that I am is that I'm just a traditional black and white panda. I mean, come on. I got a shirt that says, let's make a panda. And
who convinced you to get that shirt, by the way?
My wife convinced me to get it, and we have a cub over there. He's not black and white, but I mean, he's a cub. He's a panda cub. And then you got Mrs. Panda, and then you got Panda. So, all right, great question. Thank you very much, MC Gaming. I do appreciate it. So the next question, which I have to kind of, you know, jump on up here, comes from Shannon, a really good Australian chick for us.
That was the worst accent.
I know,
ever.
It's like the worst. I'm going to start that
She's
going to
reach through the screen
and
smack
me. I can't do an Australian accent.
Clearly, you should stop trying.
I know. There's going to be so many comments be like, you suck! Your accent sucks.
Your Australian
and New Zealand accent. I mean, they're very kind of similar. I mean, they're
careful. You don't want to piss anybody off by saying that.
I'm sorry.
Calling Kiwi and Aussie, they don't like that. I've heard.
Oh, I'm so sorry, Matt. Anyways, the question from Shannon was, what is your biggest source of inspiration for having started YouTube? And I think that was the question that you were implying that has, kind of some significance as to where my channel name came from. Or is there an actual question?
No, there's an actual question.
Oh, okay.
I think there's actually two questions.
Yeah.
One is how you got your name, and the other one was something else.
Yeah. Anyways, the biggest source of my inspiration for having started YouTube, first off, let me show you the first sort of source of inspiration. My amazing wife, Mrs. Panda, has helped me thrive and push for me to start trying to do YouTube, especially after I got my computer. You know, for months I was just going back and forth, going, "Oh my God, I'm not going to be good enough. Why should I start YouTube? No one's going to watch my shit. Why, I'm just going to completely suck. No one's going to ever check out my channel." And never is a long time. And I mean, look at me now, though. Look at the channel now. We have 336 subscribers, and we're still climbing. I mean, we're doing fantastic as a fuzzy family. We're doing great. But that was the first inspiration. The second inspiration is, this little guy down here. If you guys are able to see him at all. He's CP's right now, but that is the second inspiration as to why I wanted to start doing YouTube, was to kind of show the fact that I'm trying to show my son when he ends up watching the videos in the future, that no matter how often you kick yourself down, or if you're afraid of a certain dream, you push that dream to the side for the longest time, and until you finally just say, "Fuck it, I'm just gonna go ahead and do it," because, as Shia LaBeouf just says, "Just do it."
You should probably never do that again.
Yeah, I'm never gonna ever do that again. I'm so sorry. That was the most embarrassing thing in this video.
maybe the fake crying is the most embarrassing.
Yeah, true. Anyways, but the third biggest thing is, as I answered Bloodshot's question, which was, what made me start trying to do YouTube? And again, it's going back to seeing so many other players, so many other YouTubers having fun just doing it, and meeting other people. Like, just having the capability of meeting other players, because for the longest time I was so timid and scared when it came to trying to play with other people, especially PvP games. I hate playing PvP games with a passion.
I second that.
It's just because of the fact that you've got so many players who are unfriendly, and they just are...
There's no camaraderie.
Yeah, there's no camaraderie, there's no compassion, there's no, what is it, sportsmanship.
Yeah, it's all anger.
Everything is, nowadays is, I'm better than this person. If I'm not better, I'm going to get pissed off because they're doing something better than me.
Yeah, and then 12-year-olds insult your mother.
And I'm not that way. I hate acting that way. I hate saying that I'm better than this person, or I do better than this person, or... I hate playing against other people, and then I end up doing a game a lot better and feeling that way.
Or you suck at it.
And I suck at it, and people make fun of it. I mean, there's just so many different things that, makes me feel like shit when it comes to playing PvP games. And for those of you who don't know what PvP stands for, which 90% of this fucking world now knows, PvP stands for player versus player. And I have such a hard time playing against other people. It's not that I suck or anything else like that. It's just because they're unsportsmanlike. There are a lot of people who are just, they don't care. They're complete jackwads when it comes to it. And, I'll still play them. It sucks sometimes, but it doesn't mean that I won't play them. That's just my standpoint. But anyways, going back to the main question is just, I haven't really taken the time to do anything else besides watch YouTubers in the past with my wife and talk about how I wanted to start YouTube, how I wanted to try and do YouTube. If it goes somewhere, fucking awesome. If it doesn't, I'm not going to cry about it.
At least you had fun.
Yeah.
That's how you did it.
I'm just going to have fun about it. You know, I'll go and play a game with a friend and I'll still enjoy myself. Or I'll play the game by myself and I'll still enjoy myself. That's all I care about. If I find a game is boring, I can't guarantee that I'm not going to play it again. Or that I am going to play it again. I don't know 100%.
It's like a gnarly bruise.
Damn. Here. Show the camera.
What, my fake?
The makeup gnarly bruise?
Yeah, fake.
It's makeup, I promise. I mean, if you look over here, you can definitely see that she's arming her arsenal to get myself, you know, gorgeously ready. But, anyways, you know, Shannon, thank you very much for asking that question. Also, I do see that you asked me another question, which I'm going to kind of subtly slip in here, which is, you asked when we're going to play together next. My wife and myself. And this is actually going to be an answer for Leah.
I'm ready whenever, as long as he's asleep.
Yeah, as long as our son is asleep, we're pretty much available to try and play.
The only problem is her trying to get a hold of me, because I'm not on my computer all the time. That's the only way
Yeah. I mean, you could always try to make space on your phone or tablet and get, like, Skype or Steam.
I had Steam on the tablet, but I took it off because I wanted to play
a game
against humanity.
Yeah. But, you know, It's basically, you know, if you ever wanted to try and play something with just me or with my wife or with the both of us, Shannon, you gotta let us know.
Yeah, anytime.
Anytime, as long as we have the free time, which you know that we're parents first before we're, I mean, in all retrospect, my wife is a YouTuber as well because she's partaken with me on the channel. So, you know, it's Mrs. Panda and Panda. I mean, the reason why it's called Panda Hub was originally,
you know,
I have a question for that. But what I was trying to get at for kind of a side explanation was the reason why it's called Panda Hub is because of the way, you know, the way that a hub works is where everybody comes and hangs out.
That is not really why that's
stupid. No, but that's one reason
but it is
to
good.
How
I like that.
That's how
like
I've used it. Yeah. That's how I view it. Is that
a question asking why.
Is that, you know, I wanted people to come and have a place that they can come and socialize and hang out with and be a part of the Fuzzy family. You know, the Fuzzy family, the way that I look at it is all of you are part of my experience with YouTube and thus, you know, sharing my experience with you guys. I think of everyone as a family member. You know, whether you're an uncle, a crazy aunt, a psychotic stepbrother.
Everybody's crazy.
Yeah, we're all crazy here.
Pretty much. Here.
Yeah. But, you know, I just... That's the whole reason as to why I thought of Panda Hub Gaming, besides the true meaning of my name.
Which I'll talk about
here shortly, but... You know, the reason why I thought of Panda Hub was because pandas are warm and fuzzy, and we needed all the place to stay and hang out and watch videos together.
If something happens and we're on Hoth, can I gut you if you die so
yeah.
We can keep CJ warm?
Yeah, here, go ahead and say that to the camera.
I just want to know if we can cut you open like a tauntaun.
Yeah.
Keep ourselves warm if you die.
Yeah, that I know it smells bad, kid, but... You know, at least it'll keep you warm.
Yeah. Well, I'm inside your daddy now.
Anyways, going on to the next question. Thank you so much, Shannon. I do appreciate it. Also, for every person I'm reading off, please, if there's a YouTube channel connected to their Twitter page, I will definitely leave a description or a link down in the description or at least a comment. Please go ahead and check out these channels as well because, you know, they definitely have helped me out through my channel and my experiences. But we're doing great so far. You know, I'm glad where we've come at the moment. So we're going right on to the next question, which is, you know, from a really good friend of mine and my wife's, Elvish Gaming.
Who's
I know, it's been so long since, but she's been busy with work, busy trying to get in with the police academy, which also, round of applause to her, you know, great job on trying to get into the police academy for where you're at, Elvish, you know, thumbs up and big props to you, I respect you very much.
That's not exactly.
I know, it's more military, but I mean, they still salute in the police, sometimes. Just depends on the district that you go to. Anyways, going on to the next question is, you know, she asked, what would you do if your channel blew up overnight? You instantly gained, and at first I thought it said 1,000 subscribers, but she said, if I instantly gained 1,000,000 subscribers.
You would cry. You would weep. Sob.
I honestly have no idea how I would react. I mean, I'm already tearing up right now just thinking about it because, you know, I really don't know what I would say or do. I mean, it's kind of a thought that I don't want to ever think about just because of the fact that, you know, it makes me feel like that I've done something with this channel, not like I haven't already. But, you know, just to kind of prevent myself from catching fire here. But, you know, I don't know.
Like that. Expect the worst, hope for the best.
Yeah, expect for the worst, hope for the best is how Mrs. Panda says it. I mean, I don't know. I can't think of it like that. I can't imagine myself being at 1,000,000 subscribers, especially overnight. It's just...
Would you be so scared with the pressure?
No, honestly. I honestly wouldn't feel any type of pressure.
See, if it was me, I'd be terrified. God, now I have to impress people.
I mean, but that's just subscribers, though. That isn't counting views.
Well, yeah, but still.
But,
that's
you know...
That's how people interested.
Yeah, I mean...
People that care.
I don't want to sound like an asshole trying to explain this. I feel like I'm just being a dick.
You would be very happy.
I would. I really would. I would be.
I think you'd be a little shocked.
I would be extremely shocked, honestly. I wouldn't know how to answer it. And where the fuck did my drink go? I lost my drink. But I want tea. But anyways, I would, you know, I would have no words to be able to express my gratitude if I had 1,000,000 plus subscribers. I just would kind of be baffled and be like, wow, a lot of people watch my shit. I must be that either entertaining or I have a lot of people feeling pity for me.
1,000,000 people have taken pity on my soul.
I mean, you know, it's kind of hard to think about. I don't know how I would feel besides just happy and overwhelmed with, you know, this massive interest all of a sudden. But thank you, Elvish. I greatly appreciate the question. You know, we're going to go on to a couple of comments as well. You know, I have Summer Rose Bronwyn. She says congratulations, and you know, I just wanted to say thank you very much, Summer, for following the channel as well as following the Twitter page. And I also do have the same type of question that I got from Bloodshot, which was what inspired me to be a YouTuber. And going back to it, it's mainly it was just trying to share my experience and a lot of other major YouTubers who have millions of subscribers, and that, again, that's not my goal. My main goal is to bring entertainment and joy to my viewers. That's my final end goal. I've got a couple more,
they're just specific, straightforward.
So, I've got a question from Taz Ho.
Well, maybe you should answer the one underneath that first, because it kind of pertains to that.
Okay, well, I apologize, Taz. I'm going to end up having to skip you. I'm so sorry.
We're just saving this.
We're,
We want to savor it. Know that question is coming.
That question is coming.
You got to prepare yourself.
So, we're going to be doing gaming with Greg?
Yeah, I would do that one.
Okay,
it'll be easier to explain.
Why, the question from gaming with Greg, the question is, and I think both of us should kind of be in this shot.
Oh, okay. I don't know why, though. You could very easily explain it.
Well, I mean, it just your reaction with it kind of helps too, and you can help explain it.
Okay.
So, the reason why Panda Hub was originally Panda was my nickname from my wife, which came from her Nana.
Yeah.
Her grandmother, and one day. When she was living in another city, she used to live in Phoenix, Arizona, and I live in Tucson, Arizona. We both live in Tucson now, but I called her grandmother's house one day trying to talk to her.
I was outside.
And she was outside, nowhere near her phone, and her grandmother answered the phone. And she's like, "Hello?" And I said, "Hi, this is Taryn. I'm trying to reach Leah, so you know, if it'd be possible, I'd like to be able to talk with Leah." She's like, "Oh, she's not here at the moment. I'll make sure she gives you a call back later," and then she hangs up the phone. About a couple minutes later, I get a phone call, and my girlfriend at the time, Leah, is laughing hysterically over the phone. "Why are you laughing hysterically?" I asked. And
because when you said my name, "This is Taryn," she didn't hear you and she thought you said Panda. So forever that was your nickname after that.
So basically what had happened was her grandmother misheard when I was explaining that my name is Taryn and I'm trying to reach Leah. She thought I said Panda.
When I walked in, she's like, "I feel so bad. Taryn called you and I didn't know who it was. And I thought he said Panda, but I just realized that it was Taryn."
And so after her grandmother hung up the phone, Leah walks in a couple minutes later and ends up calling me back and is laughing and says, "So you know, my grandmother just said that you called and she thought your name was Panda." And she thought I said, "This is Panda," and was like, "Well, you know, Leah isn't here and I'll make sure that she gives you a call back." And then, you know, apparently she thought to herself that one of her father's friends was calling in to speak with him, but was requesting Leah instead. And she kind of thought was, you know, why is one of his friends...
Well, she sat there and she was like, "Panda," and she was like, "Wait, I think..." She put the Tucson number and everything together, and she was like, "It was Taryn." She figured it out. She's very smart.
And that kind of goes hand in hand with the description for my nickname to Tazhole's question of, well, what made you decide to pick a panda as my symbolic figure?
Because it's been your nickname for so long.
Yeah, it's been my nickname for so long, and I know that I'm not a husky dude. I mean, I'm kind of broad.
Well, there's a story
kind of
behind
tall,
it.
But there's a story behind it, and, you know, I mean, it's not like the most...
You can keep that on yourself.
You're going to have to do makeup here shortly.
You didn't explain the hub part of Panda Hub.
Oh, yeah, my last name.
Yeah, your last name.
My last name has hub in the first three. And, you know, so Panda Hub came from my nickname and the first three of my last name. So if you don't do the math, that's how the mathematic works. You know, 2 + 2 = 4. Panda Hub plus Hub. Panda plus Hub equals Panda Hub. Or Fish. Up to you.
No, I thought that was Triangle plus Triangle.
I think it's Spade plus Spade equals Fish.
That's a weird fish.
Yeah.
That's a fish with two faces.
But,
your last one.
Well,
did you want to touch on the symbolism?
I still want to touch up on the symbolism. Another reason why I picked Panda was because, you know, pandas are supposed to be safe, cuddly, friendly. That's how they're
like
portrayed as. You know, as a tauntaun is not always safe, cuddly, and friendly.
When they're dead and cut open and emptied, they are.
I'm glad I could be your meat suit.
Only if it were on Hoth and you died. And we needed to keep warm.
Or Antarctica?
No, only Hoth.
Oh.
Hoth is the only place.
That's the only place legal to slice someone open and utilize their heat?
Yeah. Well, you know, CJ would fit.
You know, and the reason why Panda was because I wanted to show that I'm friendly and kind and welcoming and warm and not a tauntaun.
But tauntauns are so cute.
They freaking look like, you know, what a goat and a demon would end up having together.
Hey, don't you be dissing my tauntauns now. I will sick one on you. Yeah, he'll flip you like he did Luke. You just be careful. There won't be no Han Solo there to save you. You will freeze to death.
I love you too.
This is quality content.
Oh yeah. Just hearing us bicker back and forth. It's the most
playful banter.
Yeah. Fortunately. And when
like
I'm
a panda when you take away their bamboo.
Yes, like a panda when you take away their bamboo. Which goes on to our next question. And our final
segue.
Question. Yep. From DC Games, they ask, what is my favorite bamboo recipe? And this is going to sound shocking, but I've never had bamboo.
How do you survive?
I know. The audacity. But,
I've never had sugar cane? That's kind of like bamboo.
I've never had sugar cane either.
Sugar cane is good.
But I wouldn't be opposed to trying some bamboo stock soup or something. Or something bamboo based. Is that stereotyping myself?
If you get really famous one day, so people are just going
to be sending me. Yeah, so many people are going to be sending me bamboo recipes
it's
and food.
Like, it's like Fluffy in the chocolate cake.
Right. Right. Or
one time
or Jack with Sam.
Yeah, he gets all the Sams.
Yeah. Or Pewds with the bro fist or Mark with the dwarf staff.
Bamboo is your symbol.
Yeah, Mao is my symbol and bamboo is
Mao is like your mascot.
Yeah. Mao is my mascot and Mao is somewhere.
He's hiding.
Yeah.
He's shy right now.
But so many people are probably gonna send me bamboo. So fucking hysterical.
I'm gonna buy you one of those little
office plant
bamboos
and I'm just gonna go ahead and slice off a little bit and just be like,
it really just tastes terrible, but I'm gonna do it anyway. Do it for the views.
Why am I doing this anyways? What is wrong with me? But thank you all so much for taking the time and asking me questions and leaving comments. You know, and I didn't really have, you know, any major plans besides the 300 subs questionnaire. Oh my God.
Nothing.
Chaos. But, you know, I definitely want to say thank you so much for asking the questions. And the next part of this is going to be starting here in just a couple of minutes. I'm going to take a little bit of a segue, kind of break this down, and there's going to be a small intermission. You'll end up seeing it here shortly. But we're going to do an intermission before I start actually getting makeup put onto my face. I might trim down the beard. I don't know.
You only have to do that if you want to.
But I'm also going to prepare myself mentally.
It washes off with water. It's not like it's going to damage you.
Well, I know. Anyways, be right back, you guys. And also, just want to say again, thank you very much for coming and checking out the 300 sub special. And we will be right back. Stay fuzzy.
And scare me.
Welcome back from the intermission, folks. My name is Panda Hub. This is my gorgeous wife, Mrs. Panda. Go ahead, make that face again. And gone off of Unicycle's request, which I will add right here.
Now you're gonna have to screenshot that. Have fun.
No. All I have to do is take.
You got
this. But he was asking as to when my wife was gonna be doing my makeup. And she's been pestering me for the longest time.
No, I didn't pester you, I just reminded you a couple of times that you said you would.
Yes. So. Now for the long-awaited makeup challenge. I'm going to have makeup put onto my face and record a game. So, yeah.
I love you. You're smart enough to know the classes that I got to go.
I know. I'm just going to listen to some music while this is going on.
Oh, come on. You can't hang out with me. Conversation.
Conversation?
Yep.
Is that what happens in beauty parlors? I thought. Oh.
How about that tastes nasty?
What did you put on me?
Are you gonna ask that every time I put something on you?
Might as well. It's on camera. You'd be like.
It's spray. It's setting spray. But I'm putting it on you to help.
It's NYX setting spray.
Are you going to become a makeup channel?
No. I'm not going to become a makeup channel. But
that's what we're going to do. We're just
going to show every individual piece.
Actually, you know what? We'll save that so you don't have to be tortured the whole time. We'll do your eyes first.
Save, what is that?
Foundation, it goes all over your face.
Then put the fucking foundation on first. I thought foundation goes on first anyways.
Doesn't have to.
Oh.
It just depends on, because if you're going to do something that's going to make eyeshadow fall on your face after you've done that, you'll want to mess it up. So. But
okay.
I don't think we have to do that. Do you want me to, okay.
I don't care.
Do you want me to do your face first or your eyes
I don't
first?
Care. Professional opinion?
I don't have one.
God damn it.
That's why I'm asking.
I have no professional opinion either. I'm not a cosmetologist.
I am not asking for a professional opinion, just what you want.
I don't care.
Thank you.
Okay. Now going on to the next part. We're going to start playing a game since I made a big promise to all of you guys to have makeup put on and for me to play a game. And then immediately after the game, once I play about 20, 30 minutes of it, depending.
I'm showering.
Huh?
I am showering.
I'm showering and also wiping my face off. And so let's go ahead, get started with this, and I will see you all in a second. Hey guys, welcome back. Sorry for that small intermission. So as you can see, I'm still wearing the lovely job that Mrs. Panda did. And we're going to go ahead and continue where we left off from the last recording, which was not very far, unfortunately. But let's definitely go ahead and get this taken care of. Just for now, because I can hardly see, I am going to be wearing my glasses, so. I look like the Yes Librarian. Quiet in the library.
You're so into yourself right now.
Huh?
You're so into yourself right now.
I'm trying to appease my state of mind.
Oh, I'm sorry. Did I crush your soul?
Ah, yes. Arkajit. Okay. Screw you, Camilla. I'm gonna go this way. And jump. Yeah, I wonder if I'm still gonna die. So. Oh. It's been so long since I've played. How the hell? Jesus. And we're going to run up this mountain like we're bosses. Because we own this mountain. Whoa. Okay, frost troll randomly. Hit you in the groin. Yeah. No, no, stay away. Stay away, take the arrow to the knee. Go get married. Have a shot in the butt. Yes, yes, take it in the groin and take it in the head. Oh, yeah, well, in the back, okay. Good enough. Alright, get my arrows back. I don't want any troll fat. Alright. Can we hit them from this distance? Oops. Apparently. Go ahead and shoot.
Sorry to interrupt you. Can you help me with my computer and find my board, please?
Sure.
Sorry.
Should have asked me that beforehand.
Well, I didn't.
I'm giving you shit. Cord. Computer. That's fine. Okay. Oh, that was a beautiful shot. Another beautiful shot. Oh, dick. I want your orcish armor. But it's heavy. Ow. Casted. You gonna fall off the mountain? Fall off the mountain. I know it's kind of cheap just standing there shooting at him, but I mean, the bastard was trying to kill me, so you know, he has every right to die. I need your gold, I need my arrows. It's all heavy. I need light armor. Okay, and then let me get my arrows back from you. What is it with you bastards fucking carrying goddamn heavy shit? Huh? Wait, what? Am I over encumbered? No, not even. Okay, weapons. Orcish bow. Sure. Okay, that seems a little annoying to have to fucking hold down shift. I don't know what the hell happened. Oop. I don't want to have to wait. People's attention. Yes, no, maybe. Hello. There we are. Can I reach? Can I reach? Thank you. Oh, yeah. Oh, dick. Nope. I'll take that. Oh, you have dwarven arrows. I mean, I have orcish, but still. Take your gold. We're doing good so far. Doing great. As soon as we get through Bleak Falls and make our way to White Run, then I think that's when I'll go ahead and probably end the episode. Take that. Those fucking arrows. Wasted. Wasted.
Stop wasting your arrows.
I can't help it. The ground deserves them just as much as the enemy. Just gonna go ahead and enter here. Doing great so far. We're doing fantastic. Alright, so like I said, as soon as we get through Bleak Falls, then once we're done with that, go over to White Run. Shoot this guy in the butt. Or in the back of the head. Good night. I will take your arrows. Oh, and you have gold. I'll take your gold as well. That was a really, really good shot, though. Cool. What did I just pick up? Okay. Moving right along. Keep rolling, 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 rolling. Keep rolling, 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 rolling. Keep rolling, 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 rolling. Alright, so we're making our way great. Hopefully be able to shoot this bastard. Shoot you in the thigh. Shoot you while you're down. Shoot you again. Can't believe I missed the first time, but whatever. Okay. What was it? Snake fish. Snake fish. Right? Yeah. Fall. Oh my goodness, how often am I gonna miss the fucking skeever? Die, you rat! Dick. Like my mouse movement's been limited. Lesser soul gem. Yeah, I'll take those. All right, cool. Pickpocketing. Let's see, I'm going down the spiral staircase. Going down spiral staircase. Yeah. Paralysis poison. Let's see, what weapons do I have again? Dwarvish arrows. So either let him run or shoot him in the dick. I chose to shoot him in the dick. Maybe. No, I got him in the thigh. Damn it. Wishful thinking. Golden claw. Journal. I think that's about good. What else? Another stone. Another stone. Okay. Crouch. Shoot him in the arm through the rib. That was a fantastic shot. And we're gonna copy the same shot. Oh, sort of. Just stay down. Thank you. Alright, do you guys have anything good at all? Gold. My arrow. Okay. That was the first shot that I fucking missed. Dicks! Oh yeah, I forgot I don't set off those anymore. You can't touch this. No, can't touch this. No, can't touch this. Shoot you in the ass. Then in the face. Do you like my arrow? I hope it tastes savory. Savory arrow. Okay. Then. Oh, that bow. Oh, yes. Woohoo! I'll pull back the arrow and let it fly like a white guy. Oops. Headshot. Come on. Good night. Good night. I'm not worried about it. Run. How many shots do you have to take before you go down? Apparently 4. And I can only pull back 2. Bastard. Okay. Go pull the chain. You're yanking my chain. I am not yanking your chain, I promise. I just need to pull this chain. Good night. Woo! That was easy. Okay, we're gonna go up here. Hello?
Just lipstick?
No, I'm wearing the rest of it.
Oh, okay.
It's just with my glasses, it's hard to see.
Oh. That's awesome.
Yeah.
When were you supposed to get your permanent done for your tooth? Wasn't that supposed to be today?
Yeah, I think it was today, and I forgot. I didn't get a reminder call either.
Maybe it's not until next week.
Look at your wallet, at your cards.
They didn't give me a card. I was supposed to receive a text, but I never received it.
Call them on Monday then. It is hot as heck in here. Hey!
What'd she do?
She nipped at him. No, just.
Get.
That's not very nice, Harley. Don't you wolf at me. She been out recently?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. She was out for a good, decent amount of time, too.
That wasn't very nice. You be nice. Okay? You be nice.
Alright, going into the sanctum.
There's enough food left to feed her.
That's a double serving that she already got, so...
When?
This afternoon.
No, because this morning, I knew exactly how much was left.
Okay. Another part that I have to edit out. Oof. No. What sends the axe flying? Arrows. Okay. Come on. Come on. Yep. Good night. Midair axe. Someone play the axe. Is it? Oh, I thought it was an easy access at that point. Let's see, what was it? Moth, bear, owl, or bear, owl, moth. I'm trying to remember. Claw, bear, moth, owl. Gotta hoot like an owl. That's the only way to bring this door down. Gotta hoot like an owl. Go and get the first shout or thoom. Thoom. Thoom, 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 thoom. Come on. Come on, Dreadlord. Oh, Scourgelord. Oh, you're a Frost Scourgelord. Oh, God. Ugh, dick. Back me into a wall, dick. Shoot you in the dick for that. Oh, I hit your hand. Goodbye. Oh, I shouldn't have gone through so many arrows with you, but I did anyways. Okay. Linen wraps, potent frenzy potion, poison. Poison, right? Poison. Poison. Poison, I say. No, I am not picking up the fucking beacon of Meridia. Yeah, no. No, no, no. The beacon of Meridia. Class mace. Because we want to be as ninja and bow-like as possible. Whee! Okay. Open sesame. So we finally finished Bleak Falls. Next, we're gonna go out to White Run, and once we get to White Run, I think this is where I might end it. I know I had said in the last video that I was gonna be leveling up a little bit and trying to get ahead. And I do apologize if you see me, you know, start off at level 4 and I'm currently at level 37. It's just because, you know, I wanted to make it a little bit more interesting, not like easy per se, because I was still getting my ass kicked, but I wanted to make sure that we would have at least a little bit of fun while I was playing an archer. I'm not going to say that it's going to be that way all the time, but we'll definitely try to have some fun with this. Now just going to make our way to White Run, but since we are close to Riverwood, let's go ahead and fast travel to that, and then kind of make our way from there. That or, let's make our way from Riverwood to White Run. Alright, so we're doing good so far. Oh shit, courier. I don't care about the museum. And I'll return the Golden Claw here shortly. Probably in the next episode. A horse? A random horse. Cool. I have no complaints. Hello?
Can I just turn down the air?
Okay, so making great progress. Making our way downtown, walking fast, faces passive, homebound. Sounded like a wolf. Imperial bastards. Why don't I just get off the fucking horse? If you didn't hesitate, you would have probably shot me by now. Last witness killed. Yes. I have a couple of items that I could provide to you that I'm not using. I shall give you the mace. I do not have anything else, no. Oh, horse is leaving me, so that's cool. That's fine. Ugh. I may have just broken my legs. I just want to shot it. Shield sister. Oh my goodness. Become a freaking cat to a werewolf. Yes, let's definitely do that. take my arrow. Run. Rain is so pretty. My people. Hello, my people. What do you have? Okay, common soul gem, ebony ingots, grand soul gems. I'm gonna talk the crap out of you. Any arrows? I appreciate that. Alright, so we've now officially made it to Whiterun, but I'm going to make it inside of Whiterun first before we end up ending the episode here today. Okay. Cool. So I'll make it inside, and as soon as we make it inside, we're going to go ahead, save, and probably finish up around here. Alright. Go ahead. Alright, guys. Well, this is all the time that I have for this episode and for this special tonight, today, evening, morning, wherever you are when you watch this. But I just want to thank you again. You know, I wouldn't have done this for, well, I mean, I probably would have done it for my wife if she just asked, but still, you know, I wouldn't have done this for anybody else besides maybe my wife or for you guys. Otherwise, you know, you guys give me the full reason as to why I'm continuing YouTube, besides the constant support from my wife and my friends. But, you know, I just want to thank you again so much for believing in me and taking the time to check out my content. And, you know, I can't wait till we hit the next milestone. Once I hit 500, probably going to be a while before we end up doing another major special, but right now, let's just go ahead, get up to 350, and start sharing the rest of the Fuzzy Family love with the rest of the world. Until next time, my Fuzzy Family, I will see you in next video. Peace out, my Fuzzy Family.